In this video, we'll look at how to use the DevExpress HTML and CSS templates to design your apps. Before we start, let me recommend that you enable DirectX in your project settings. We'll create item animations and other visual effects, and these are much faster rendered when using DirectX instead of the standard GDI. Here on my sample application, I've got the data grid with a Win Explorer view applied. Those who've already used this view know that it emulates the standard Windows Explorer, and like its prototype, it's limited in the amount of data view items it can display. Under the column set group in Visual Studio, you'll find a set of available fields: photo, caption, description, checkbox, and a few more. And here's how this setup looks at runtime. What we're going to do is turn this layout into something incredible. We'll copy the demo module from our HTML demo that looks like this. Pretty awesome, huh? Now invoke the smart tag menu for the data grid and choose Edit Active HTML Template. Note the word active. Win Explorer View has multiple styles: large, medium, tiles, table, and others. When you select Edit Active HTML Template, you edit a template for the currently active style. Right now, I'm going to create a template for the default medium style. So if I'd switch to, say, extra large, this template won't be active. HTML templates are created in a syntax editor tool that consists of two panels for HTML and CSS, and a preview panel. Let's start with something simple. I'll create a div block with a sample text inside. Note that as soon as I hit the first letter, the built-in autocomplete suggests the div tag. Now let's specify a class for this div element. If you've ever created web markup, you probably know that HTML elements often store their appearance settings in CSS styles, assigned to elements via the class keyword. I set the class property for my root div element to container style. Control space the style name, and the editor will suggest to create a new style with this name. You can now see the blank container style added. I'm going to fill this style with a few size and display settings. You can read about what each parameter does in our documentation. When my root container element is ready, I'm going to create a child div element with the item class. This one has a few extra parameters, namely background color and shadow. This element will be a client area for our data records. Now let's finally add some real content. Create a new div element with an image inside, the img element. Once again, I set CSS styles for both of these newly added div elements: sizes, paddings, alignment parameters, and so on. When it's done, I'll set the src parameter of my img tag. This parameter specifies the actual image this element shows. I want to retrieve images from a data source, so I'll enter a dollar sign and figured brackets, and then press the same control space hotkey we used to create new CSS styles. This combination allows me to view all data fields of a source to which my data grid is connected. I'll choose the photo data field, save the template, and run the app to see the current result. As you can see, we now have record images retrieved from a data source. Let's add more data to our cards. Using the same techniques as before, I am going to add a div element with the item info outer class. This item will host all elements below the record photo. The first element it will contain is a div with the item info class, which in turn hosts four other divs that retrieve string data from a data source: trademark name, modification, torque, horsepower, and so on. Note that this amount of information already exceeds what you can show with a standard Win Explorer view. CSS styles for parent container div elements are very simple again. The interesting part here is the color that starts with the at sign. This sign allows you to select colors from our DevExpress skin palettes. We'll get to this later. Styles for data-bound div elements specify custom font settings, and the category class has a custom background color. You can track your progress in the preview panel as you type the code. Let's run the app to see what we've got so far. I don't know about you, but I think this is already some pretty stunning UI. The cards look tidy and clean, and it lays out all the required information nicely. Before we add our final elements, let's push our current template even further by adding a sub-style for the item style. The item hover style allows us to modify item appearance when items are, well, hovered. In this case, we'll modify item shadows. Hovered items will show a more pronounced shadow, which will make them look elevated. For our final step, I'm going to add a button. Yes, HTML templates allow you to turn a simple div element into a clickable button. For now, this is just a regular div, and I'm setting its CSS style properties. Font, shadows, margins, paddings, all this should already be familiar to you. Same as for the item style. I add a button hover style that will highlight my button when users hover over it. This hover style is a bit more fancy than simple shadows for the item element. Here we're using the highlight alternate value that retrieves a corresponding color from a vector skin or palette. Depending on the current skin, this color differs. In the default skin palette, that's blue. Or dark green and pine. Or violet. Or pink in the dragonfly palette for the Bezier skin. You get the idea. Now our button div is only called a button, but it cannot be clicked. Let's fix that. Type on, and the syntax editor will suggest on click. That's exactly what we need. Enter the name of the method that should be called when this element is clicked. Save the template and implement this method in code. In my sample, that's a simple message box show method that displays detailed car info. Check out our demo to see how you can replace this message box with something that fits our awesome HTML design. And that's all for now. Please let us know what videos you would love to see next. Should we continue this sample and add a web style pop-up for items, or a video that demonstrates all features of our syntax editor? Let us know in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified whenever we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.